rest of my career, my second career, unpaid second career goal, to change the mindset of people littering. Topic of trash is on everybody's mind right now. So it's a easier time to get volunteers because they're sick of this.
This is your community. You want to keep it clean, you want to be involved. What greater feeling do you get out of it? So it's very rewarding.
We're going to work along Rinaldi.
You're going to work along Rinaldi?
Along Rinaldi, along the fence line there, okay. On both sides.
We're involved in Adopt a Street, Adopt a Highway, and actually cleaning the streets in your community. Picking up trash has been in my makeup since my first career, which was in the restaurant business. It just is ingrained in me to do that. Then realized that the communities have a lot of trash, the highways, and I want to go into the schools and start working with the kids to train them to look on the ground and don't just walk over trash, to learn to pick it up, because they're going to inherit this world, and it should be a clean world that they inherit, and they're part of that.
Because it's a huge amount of trash on this street.
I saw somebody.
And there's a huge amount of trash on this. Topanga's terrible. So what we usually do is go up one street, cross over, and go down the other, taking about 2 hours. So an hour up, if you want to spend 2 hours, which is we usually do.
A daily walk during COVID in particular was to get out. So I said, okay, there's a lot of trash on these streets. I'm just going to bring a bag while I do my walk. And it gives me a focus for my walk too. The walks actually go a lot faster. And I kind of came up with a slogan for VCC based on that. Take a walk, take a bag, take some trash off the street.
A wonderful morning for a cleanup. We've got a great crew out here. The weather's wonderful. So yeah, I think we can get a lot accomplished. Certainly get as much as we can before it gets too hot. But yeah, it's a wonderful morning for a cleanup. It always is, isn't it?
I love hiking. I love the environment. Climate is really important to me. So I just wanted to do something. You know, I'm driving, I see trash in the neighborhoods, and I just wanted to start here and, you know, hopefully get a part of an organization who, you know, is as passionate about it as I am.
We pulled out 24 carts on the 118 off-ramp on Reseda. They were all back in the woods there.
Building an organization takes time. And if I could just, through any social media, be able to just get one volunteer who actually goes out and will pick up trash every day, that's 365 days a year. That's 365 people cleaning a block or cleaning a section. So that's going to get our valley. That's going to get our America cleaner.
This program gives me a reason for getting out of bed in the morning. I do it as much for the cleanup as for the exercise. I'm the trash monitor on my street.
A lot of people want to volunteer, but not everybody can pick up trash. They ask, what can I do? Gina, a lady who's on a walker, is a perfect example. I needed somebody to man a reception table at the LA River. She does a great job at signing people in, making sure they get their hand sanitizer and their gloves and their equipment, and it's perfect for her.
Thank you. Uh-huh. Glad you guys are doing this. I'm glad we can be a part of it. How are you doing?
I'm just glad to be a part of what Jill does. She does wonderful things for our community, and it's really appreciated by those of us who don't appreciate the trash.
I can't state this enough. I'm a big believer in a broken window theory, that when things start to go downhill, they really start to go downhill. I've been with Jill, working with her about 3 months now. We've picked up, I think, over 6,000 pounds of trash over this time, and I think it's making a great difference. So anybody listening to this, I implore you, join us or just go out and commit to picking up a bag of trash every once in a while, and it would make an unbelievable difference.
Home Depot is a great supporter, and that is through Councilman John Lee's office. It was his suggestion to fund me in some way, give me that. And the way that he could do that was go to the Home Depot and see if they could grant me money and or product equipment that would support the growth of VCC. And that's exactly what happened. I believe that the leader needs to be a leader, and we don't need a verbal leader. You lead by example, always. My mother is 97 and still volunteers, so it's in my genes to be a worker and have energy. I am 70, proud that I'm 70 and that I'm leading an organization, because people should know you're only as old as you think you are.
I am so fascinated by how amazing just this grassroots people that just want to get stuff done, this volunteers planning community run by Jill is such an inspiration, and I'm having such a blast cleaning up stuff, because honestly, I got sick of seeing stuff. And so now there's an opportunity because she's organizing it for me to do it.
It keeps you healthy. It keeps you outdoors in fresh air. You meet great people, and as we socialize with great people, you know, we become more vibrant ourselves. It keeps us young.